Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the National Anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome to the Bainbridge High School Class of 2020 virtual graduation ceremony, the first of its kind and rather fitting for a class that has a story like no other in recent history. Hello. My name is Austin Aldridge, and first and foremost, I would like to thank each and every person, even though I can't see you and you can't see me, who has joined tonight to share in this milestone moment. Secondly, I would like to extend a huge thank you to Superintendent Cochran, Mr. Matthews, and all the others who have been working diligently to celebrate the seniors. Not to mention, we are technically still graduating on time, so kudos to the Bearcat family. This is certainly not a time that we wanted to have to endure, but at least we'll have a good story to tell, right? I mean, I'll get to brag that I became a biomedical engineer and didn't really even have to finish high school. All jokes aside, though, when people told me that your senior year flies, I knew it was probably true. I just wasn't expecting it to zoom. Thank you, COVID-19. These are, however, unprecedented times where things are much different than anyone could have ever imagined. Yet what choice do we have but to make the most out of it and be thankful for the memories we have made over the past 4 years? Even though we kind of did miss a little school last year, too, after Hurricane Michael. But hey, at least we put a title under our belt. Powderpuff, of course, two-time champs. And rumor has it that our Powderpuff cheerleaders are the best in Bainbridge High School history. On top of this, though, think about all we have accomplished academically and in extracurricular activities. 340 graduates, 95 potential honor graduates, numerous region championships, a state championship in football, multiple appearances in the state playoffs, a band program with 35 years of superior ratings at festival, and a theater program that has been revamped and has provided excellent productions over the last 4 years, and the list just keeps going. Our class knows what it takes to be successful. We are resilient. We know what it really means to be a Bearcat, and we will always bleed purple and gold. We might have missed part of our senior year due to a virus that makes people obsess over toilet paper and has added a new vocab term to our daily conversations, social distancing. Oh, hey, Dr. Chambers, told you our vocabularies were an increase at some point. All joking aside, though, our senior year has been impacted by a pandemic that has left no student or family untouched. And yet, even though our senior year didn't play out with normalcy, none of this changes what we've already been through together. None of this changes what each and every teacher has done for us over the past 4 years or how our families have supported us. For that, we are truly blessed. So to my classmates, I hope you all like the dad jokes, and I hope you all still laugh when you hear them, if and when we get to walk. But preferably when, of course. So in closing, the class of 2020. We started as 9/11 babies, and we matured into a bunch of quarantines. But our story doesn't stop here. Tonight, we leave our mark on Bainbridge High School, and our class thanks each of you who have chosen to join us. Parents, family members near and far, special loved ones, friends, community members, Board of Education, and all the teachers and staff of the Decatur County School System. Welcome to our graduation, and I invite you to enjoy the personal touch as you watch each graduate story come to life during what we can easily guess is the largest graduation ceremony ever in the history of Bainbridge High School. And don't tell Mr. Matthews, but I think we figured out a way around the 6-ticket limit. So as Dr. Seuss would say, congratulations, today is our day. We're off to great places. We're off and away. As you get on your way, I leave you a special saying for my own personal family and faith in God. Remember who you are and whose you are. Stay focused. Remain true to who you are, and do not be afraid to work hard. You're on your own. You know what you know. And you are the guy or gal who decide where to go. Oh, the places we'll go. Again, thank you for joining us tonight. And to my class, once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. After Eric Martinez Juarez gave his valedictorian speech in 2010, there has not been another Hispanic deliver a speech at a Bainbridge High School graduation. So I feel honored to be here as the next Latina delivering the 2020 senior speech. It's an honor to be able to represent mi raza mexicana. Anyways, if you know me well, you know I hate writing, but once I get into it, I become a dissertation writer, to quote Dr. Chambers. So I will try my best to keep this short. Well, class of 2020, we made it. Today we graduate after 12 long years. I know this is not the way we expected our graduation to be, but I also know that God does everything for a reason. We may be separate, but at the same time, we're together. Everyone is at a different place watching this video, but that doesn't change the fact that we are united, because we are a family. Some of y'all may not know me or even know of my existence, but that's okay, because I see y'all as family. We've grown up together, we've made memories together, and we struggle together. And all of that equals family. This is going to be quite a memorable year in graduation because all of our plans and events leading up to graduation were torn apart by COVID-19. We didn't know that March 13, 2020 was our last day as high school students. We didn't get to say our goodbyes to teachers, staff, and friends because we were expecting to be back in 3 weeks. Little did we know, it was all over. Coronavirus brought our senior year to an end very quickly, but life doesn't pause. Well, it kind of did, but not for long. In just a couple of months, everyone will be going their own way. Some will enter the workforce, some will go into the military, and some will be going to college. I want to wish each and every one of y'all good luck. I have faith that everyone is going to find their passion and thrive in life because no one can stop the class of 2020. We are capable of doing anything that we put our minds to. We are graduating at the start of a new decade, which means we are becoming the future of this country. Not only do I want to wish y'all luck, but I also want to remind you to not give up on your dreams and not to let anyone keep you from reaching your goals. I want to tell you a little about my life. I am the daughter of two Mexican immigrants. They came here looking for a better future for themselves and their children. And boy, let me tell you, I'm so glad they did. After years of arduous labor, they are able to say that they are living way better than back in their home country. I'm not saying Mexico is a horrible country, because it's not. Mexico is an absolute beauty. Although I have only traveled to Mexico twice, I can say I absolutely love it. But I would not want to live there because I know I have a better chance of succeeding here in my beloved United States of America. My fellow classmates, do any of you recall ever asking me why do I want my grade higher than a 98 or a 99? Or why do I try so hard? Or why am I an overachiever? Well, I have your answer. I try so hard in school because my parents work just as hard to be able to provide with my necessities. I have seen my parents struggle and I have experienced their struggle. Their labor is a kind of labor I want to avoid because it is physically and mentally exhausting. So instead, I have decided to work extra hard in school so that I can have the life my parents wish they could have had. They wish they could have had the chance to attend college and to get a degree, but because of the lack of money, they didn't have a choice but to work. Today, they work really hard to be able to provide my siblings and me a better life. That's why I want to take a moment to thank them during this special moment, because every parent loves to hear words of appreciation and love for their children. Mamá, papá, en este momento les quiero dar las gracias por todo lo que han hecho por mis hermanos y yo. Ustedes cruzaron esa frontera con nada para darnos todo, incluyendo la oportunidad de cruzar un escenario con un diploma en la mano. Y hoy les puedo decir que lo lograron, porque su hija más chica ya va a recibir su diploma, pero esto no es el final. Ustedes han pasado años trabajando para que nosotros pudiéramos tener un mejor futuro. Sus sueños son ver a sus hijos realizados con una carrera exitosa. Y se los prometo que así va a ser, porque ustedes son el mejor ejemplo. Me han enseñado que la vida no es nada fácil, especialmente si no tienes un título. Pero que todo se puede si uno le echa ganas. Yo les he dicho que limpiando casas no es para mí, y mucho menos el fin. Entonces, solamente queda la opción de seguir estudiando, así que voy a escoger esa. Porque yo veo cómo llegan a la casa cansados y adoloridos, con hambre y ganas de descansar. Ver cómo se esfuerzan por mis hermanos y yo me ha hecho venir a la conclusión que quiero una mejor vida y me quiero superar. Entonces, por ustedes, mamá y papá, le voy a echar muchísimas ganas porque los amo y les quiero enseñar que nos han criado bien porque son los mejores papás que uno puede tener. Classmates, I ask you to please not overlook the hard work your parents or guardians go through to put food on your table, a roof over your head, clothes on your body, and shoes on your feet. I know that every parent's motivation is their children because they want them to have everything they need, no matter what. So So I ask you to work just as hard to give your parents or motivators what they want, which is to see you succeed. It doesn't matter if you're going to college or not, because you may have a better opportunity in the workforce, but whatever your future holds, you should always put your all in it. If you have a dream, go for it. Put yourself to the challenge, and don't let anyone hold you back. There will be obstacles on your journey towards success, but I know how strong each one of you is. When you feel like you can't take it anymore and all you want to do is give up, think about why you started that journey. Think about the people who have motivated you and believed in you no matter what. Trust me, it works. I could not have gotten to where I am today without the motivation from my best friends and my family. I want to thank Eric Juarez, who has been a family friend since I was 4 years old, for being one of my strongest motivators. He is an intelligent young man who has graduated from Harvard and continues to pursue his career as a medical doctor, who also plans to become a politician one day. He was the last Mexican-American to be on the BHS stage delivering a speech, and I have always said, I want to be the next one. Because of him, I have worked hard to get to this point. His accomplishments show you that you can do anything you put your mind to, no matter what. It doesn't matter if you're a minority, because you have the same capabilities as others if you believe in yourself. It's time Hispanics stand up for themselves and show what we are capable of. Eric, along with many other Hispanics across the country, has succeeded, which means you can too. So stop making excuses and worrying about certain barriers, because anyone can make their dreams become reality. I also want to thank you to Maria Juarez, Hannah Sprinkle, Emily Mendoza, Macy Garcia, Brenda Lucas, Marisol Magana, Vanessa Vasquez, every other student in my classes, my teachers, my counselors, and my parents, without whom I cannot be the person I am today. They believed in me every step of the way, and I know they will continue to believe in me. Those are the kind of people you should always think of when you feel like you failed, and I promise you will feel the need to work even harder, because the class of 2020 can surpass and overcome anything that comes across them, because we are the best of the best. No cap. Thank you.
I want to begin this by going ahead and saying thank you to the people who have had a huge impact on me. To my family for always being my cheerleaders and supporting me in all of my decisions and pushing me to be the best person and student I can be. To Dr. Clark and Ms. Cook, who have supported me since my Jones Wheat elementary school days and gave me the push since I was young. To Ms. June Faircloth and Ms. Rosalind Palmer for being the community leaders that installed so much faith in me. To the two teachers who have pushed me to be a better student. Thank you to Mr. Huffsteller for putting up with all of my questions in humanities, and Mr. Joseph Kelly for always being one of the sassiest teachers I know. And last but not least, thank you to Dr. Chambers for being my school mom and being there for me. I know everyone always begins their speeches by saying that they would be lying if they did not begin writing their speech 2 days before it was due. But now that I'm in these shoes, I can tell you that it is 100% the truth. It's hard to just sit down in front of a blank computer screen and recap every single memory from the last 4 years to decide which one deserves to be written about. Which one do I think impacted me, my teachers, my friends, my classmates, this high school the most? Which one do I think defined the last 4 years for me? I could have picked the day we won the state championship. That day was filled with energy that was unmatched. Ever since the moment that the buses pulled into the Mercedes-Benz Stadium, there was a shift. It was not just about the football anymore. It was the Bearcats taking on a team who had them on complete shutdown the first time they met. The season was interrupted that year by a terrible hurricane, Hurricane Michael, that shook up life as we knew it. It was an adjustment for us all, going without power or water, seeing the destruction around the town. It was devastating. The regular season was not exactly the one we all wanted. There were some losses that were not deserved, but at the first playoff game, the Bearcats began rewriting their story. And on December 11th, they finished it. On that day, Bainbridge as a whole saw a change, a shift. There was a sense of unity all through the town. It was the hope everyone needed after the storm hit. That one wasn't the story I wanted to tell, so I could have picked the day the girls' swim team won regions. I mean, that particular day is memorable for two reasons. I got to be on the winning relays with some of my best friends and claim a trophy that required hours upon hours of drowning in the freezing cold YMCA swimming pool because the heater was constantly broken and we were always getting yelled at to get off the lane ropes, especially Stokes. But more importantly, I got to witness the Heidi Chambers and Deborah Durham jumping into the cold pool at Harris County. Now that is a sight that will make you laugh. But that day was filled with so many emotions, stress and anxiousness to step up on the block, laughter at IHOP as we ate way too many carbs, joy and pride when they named us region champions. The moment when all of the girls hugged is a moment I would never give up. There were tears and there were smiles. There's a difference to simply compete with your teammates versus winning with your family, and that's what happened that day. Or I could have talked about the band trip to New York City. That week was an incredible week filled with fun and adventure, exploring new cities, eating at new restaurants, and shopping until there was no money left in your wallet. Walking down the freezing streets of Philadelphia while carrying a giant hula hoop covered in what looks like tinfoil and feels like it is going to blow away at any moment will change a person. It was very impactful to see that our small town marching band can go to a city over 900 miles away and bring joy to a people and a city. While those memories were great, high school is not defined by the huge moments. Those were only 8 days out of the 1,460 days that I could say I was a student at Bainbridge High School. The little things are what define the last 4 years of our lives. The day that we first walked in through those double doors at the front of the school and had no idea what we were all getting ourselves into. All the times we sat in either the lunchroom or the library cracking jokes with our friends. The late nights either Sonic or Walmart playing music way too loud. The days that Miss Bias's cooking class was baking cookies and we all begged our friends to save us one. The day we were all able to compete with our friends along our side in either our favorite sport or an academic club. The days our history teachers would put on movies for us to watch, painting signs as our first days of seniors and all gathering up to line up in the senior parade. Paint-ups and tailgates at either Austin's house or the football field and the pictures after the game. Walking and talking on the field after football or soccer games. Laughing in the locker room after winning a game. High school is defined by the little moments that made us laugh or smile, the ones we never realized we would miss. I know the last few months we had of our senior year did not quite go as planned. We did not get to go to our senior prom or go on one last spring break with all of our friends. We did not get to do graduation practice or have baccalaureate. Many of us did not get to finish our sports seasons or get recognition on our senior nights. We were constantly being told this would be over and school would go back to normal. None of us realized that March 13th would be our last time walking through the hallways as a student. It seems as if our book is closed and our stories are over, but they're not. Our class is one of the strongest to ever walk through the halls of Bainbridge High School. We were born in the year of 9/11. We went through Hurricane Michael, and now we are going through a pandemic. Our class is one of strength and resilience. So while it may seem as if our world took a complete shift and it may seem over, life is defined by the little moments just like high school. Our books aren't closed and our stories are not over. They are just simply beginning. We are all going into a new chapter of our lives, whether it be attending college, going into the workforce, or entering the military. We may not have had the typical ends for our senior year, but our class will be known as the ones who are able to make the best out of everything thrown at us. So to the class of 2020, this is our time to show everyone who we are and what we are made of, that we do not let obstacles bring us down and define us. Instead, we overcome and do better than before. It is our time to write our stories and make our change in the world. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and remember that life is about the little moments.
Hey guys, for those of you that don't know me, I'm Hannah Sprinkle. I'm not gonna lie, I'm so nervous right now, even though this is just a recording. I hate public speaking, so I'm gonna keep this short and sweet. I stress so much over what I would say because I didn't know what I wanted to say. But then it finally hit me that this is the end for us, and I suddenly knew what I wanted to say to everyone. I'm going to try not to get too sappy on y'all, but high school is over. Everything we have worked for over the last 12 years has led up to this moment. All the late night studying, the endless stress, and the practices for games and performances is over, and for some, this may come as a relief. But that also means that getting to cheer on your friends as they play in a big game, the feeling you get when you pass a test you knew you would fail, and dancing the night away at prom or homecoming is over. Our entire lives have led up to this one moment, and now it's gone. I know this is not what we expected graduation would look like, and it wasn't what anyone had planned. It's bittersweet. But that's life. Life is unpredictable, messy, and complicated, but it's also beautiful. Even though we are not physically together, we are still together. We are finishing together, we are graduating together, and we are starting our new lives together. This is when we will all go our separate ways. Some of us will go to college, some of us will get a job, and some of us will join the military, and some of us don't know what's in store for us next. We're finally adults now, big boys and girls, and we're about to begin the rest of our lives. Many of you will go on to do amazing things, and we may not expect the life we end up living. But either way, the world is ours, and I can't wait to see where life takes us. My favorite Bible verse is Jeremiah 29:11. It says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." I know some of you may not believe in the same God that I do, and some of you may not believe in a God at all. But I believe that God has a plan and purpose for each of our lives, no matter what our life will be, and this gives me comfort during these uncertain times. Life will always go according to our plans, but everything happens for a reason. So whatever life you may be living after graduation, live it to the fullest and make the most of it. We aren't guaranteed tomorrow, so be the best you that you can be today. Make an impact, create change, make this the world that you want to live in. We have so much potential to be the change that this world needs. I want to wish everyone the best in their future, and I pray that your life becomes everything that you've ever dreamed of. I'm so thankful for all of the years that we've had together and for all of the people I have met along the way. I couldn't have made it to where I am today without my family, friends, teachers, and God. My parents, sister, and grandparents have been my number one supporters throughout my whole life. They all have always believed in me and pushed me to do my best. I'm so thankful to have such an amazing family. My best friends, Diana, Macy, Maria, Emily, Marisol, Brenda, and Carly, have been by my side since middle school, and they have always made me laugh or smile, no matter what kind of day I'm having. Lastly, I want to thank every teacher who has ever taught me. You have all always gone above and beyond to teach all of us bad children. In my life, you have helped to foster my love for learning and have helped me to grow as a person. I'm so grateful that God has placed such loving and supportive people in my life. I will miss each and every one of you, but I will never forget the memories that high school has brought me. From my first day of high school, to my first time marching under the Friday night lights, to the Chicago trip, to prom, to the New York trip, and finally, to my last day walking down the halls of Bainbridge High School. These 4 years have been an amazing experience, and I wouldn't change a minute of it. This graduation wasn't what we expected, and life may not be what we expect, but I'm blessed to get to experience it with the class of 2020. We did it, guys.
Juan Mario Abreu Basulto. Ernest Lamar Addison. Austin Jason Aldridge.
Once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat.
Daniel Lamar Allen. Brandy Eugenia Anderson. Devin Jaheim Anderson. Peyton Amber Anderson. Takiara Riche Anderson. Ziuna Imona Andrews.
My name is Anna Andrews, class 2020, and it's been a long ride these 4 years, and I enjoy every single moment of it, and I'm going to further my career.
Shabreya Marie Hawkins Bailey. Alston LaShawn Baker. Sandy Nicole Baker. Traven Joshua Baker. Caesar Stevan Balderas. Ashley Kate Barber. Cora Kathleen Barrett.
My name is Cora Barrett, and I'd like to thank my family, my friends, and any teachers I've had that helped me get this far. I hope to become a successful paramedic in the future.
Abby Murray Bennett. Anna Elizabeth Bibby. Josiah Benedict Blackman. Preston Treeman Blocker. Samaya Brashe Blocker. Tristan Harley Blocker. Amara Akira Bob.
Congrats, class of 2020.
Samuel Warren Boutwell. Calvin Bowens. Randy Lamar Bradwell. Adia Marie Brannon. Jemiah Naomi Brinson.
I'm Jemiah Brinson, and I will be attending Middle Georgia State University and majoring in biology.
Ashton Elizabeth Brock.
Thank you to my family and teachers that have supported me throughout the years.
Courtney Dawn Brooks. Carson Lane Brown. Jacob Lee Brown. Jordan Jamal Brown. Kelsey Rena Brown. Michael Preston Bruce.
I'd like to thank my friends and family.
Mitchell Preston Bruce.
All right, thank my friends and family.
Mark LaQuinn Brunson. Callan Elizabeth Bryan. Tyree Lorenzo Bryant. Tyrell Alfonso Bryant. Nicholas Gray Buchanan. Dylan Christian Bullock. William McCall Burney. Marcus Antron Burse. Tiara Shante Burwell.
I want to thank my mom, my family, my teachers, and principal for pushing me to graduate.
Kevin Terrell Butler.
First of all, I'd like to thank all my family and teachers for getting me to where I am, and most of all, I'd like to thank God for giving me the strength to accomplish it.
Lyric Ariana Alice Butler.
Hi, my name is Lyric Butler. These 4 years have seemed to fly by, and I am proud to say that I am a Bainbridge High School honor graduate.
Jared Micah Bird. Lisa Caballero.
I am so excited to have completed this chapter of my life. I couldn't have done it without my family, my friends, support, and I can't wait to see what the future holds.
Megan Rachel Calhoun. Christopher Ryan Canseco. Kira Latrell Carlisle. Timothy Monte Carlisle. Denise Shakaria Chappelle. Jaheen Cheatham.
I would like to thank my family and friends for supporting me. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Cesar Shigil.
I'd like to thank my parents, teachers, and everyone who has helped me along the way. And go Bearcats.
Christopher Brian Arthur Chanel. Mikiria Ladagia Crispin. Kenneth LaFraser Clark.
Yo, it's your boy checking in. I want to say congrats to all my classmates, man. We out of here.
Nikaria Ashanti Clark. Clayton Lawrence Clemens.
My name is Clayton Clemens. I want to thank all my family and friends for helping me through the years. I couldn't do it without you guys. Thank y'all so much.
Quentin Jamal Clemens. Raymond Alexander Clyatt. Ariel Shard Colbert. Caitlin Taylor Brianna Cohn. Jackson D. Conley. Jesse Dwayne Connor. Lanisha Denise Cooper. Yuji Jalen Cotton.
Hi, my name is Yuji Cotton, and I'd like to thank the staff at BHS, my parents, my friends, and my family for making this all possible. Once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat.
Elena Lynn Cox. Emily Frances Cumby. Ashton Lee Darley. Sarah Caroline Darley. Rodnesia Elaine Dawson. Grayson Cole Dean. Haley Catherine Dean. Sebastian Ide DeRocco.
Hi, my name is Sebastian DeRocco, and I want to thank my family for making me who I am today.
James Tyler Dotson. Madeline Dawn Dollar. Elizabeth Marie Dolly. Aubrey Catherine Donaldson.
Thank you to Bainbridge High School for all the memories. Once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat.
Nicholas Trevin Douglas. Destiny Lene Duncan. China Desha Edwards. Elia Janae Newby Edwards.
Hi, my name is Adia Ellis. I am a Bainbridge High School graduate, and I would like to thank my mom and my siblings for helping me get here.
Isaiah Lee Edwards. Monica Kiera Edwards. Torrance Jeremiah Elijah. Joseph Eric Emmons. Taylor Nicole Emmons. Thomas Ryan Emmons. Jamarcus Hoyt Enzer. Juan Gabriel Escamilla Satuyo. Jamie LaShawn Esland. Bryson Randall Faircloth. Jonathan Thomas Farrington. Renee Marie Fillingame.
Hey guys, it's Renee Fillingame here, and I would like to thank everyone who has supported me through this crazy high school journey of mine. So thank you, and good luck to the rest of you guys. Bye!
Madison Elizabeth Fletcher. Anthony Jared Florence. Zykeria Lakasha Freeman. Jalen Monique Fry. Asharia Micaiah Fudge. Bruce Frederick Gadsden.
It's official.
Maya Ayana Gaines. Sierra Sala Gamble. Macy Garcia Bolanos.
Congratulations, class of 2020. We made it. I want to wish everyone the best of luck in their future, and a big thank you to everyone who supported me throughout high school and influenced me in a positive way.
Irene Garcia Morales. Nathan Richard Gibson. Colton Lawrence Givens. Grayson Alexander Lee Glisson. Kendall Levi Glover. Matthew Carlton Godby. Damon Jared Gordon. Rosalind Raina Gordon.
It's official.
Alexa Isabel Granados.
I want to thank my family for all the love and support on this journey. Congratulations to the class of 2020. We did it. Yay!
Layla Rashard Green. Allison Nicole Griffin. Jayana Jorde Grimsley. Alyssa Guerrero.
Thank you for all those years of school that... Thank you.
Keon Guy.
I am Keon Guy, a proud graduate of Bainbridge High School, and I'll be attending Georgia Southern to study psychology.
Larry Guy. Anthony Chase Hall, Bailey Marie Hall, Lacey Kirsten Hall.
Thanks to everyone who helped me get to this point, and now I'm ready to get on with the next chapter of my life. Wish everyone luck on their journey.
Cody Lynn Hansen. Arthur Rodriguez Harper.
Didn't even thought Little Rock Wave was gonna make you get wet. I'm out of here, yeah.
Caden Shiver Harrell. Michael Elizabeth Harrell. Piper Michelle Harrell. Latravion Javen Harris.
I would like to thank God, my parents, and Bainbridge High School for everything y'all did for me, and hope y'all be safe.
Shamira LaFay Hayes.
Hey guys, it's me, 2020 graduate here. I just want to say thank you to all my teachers, all my supporters who supported me.
Maesia Rubinel Henry. Clara Norma Hernandez. Quatemuc Herrera. Brejane Jean Hightower.
I am Brejane Hightower. My future plan is to become a radiologist and a certified nurse midwife.
Samaya Ishe Hines. Asija Leona Hodge. Kieran William Hodge. Austin Lake Holcomb.
Finally done with this.
Woo-hoo! Cornelia Andraja Holmes. Timesha Kiera Horn. Leah Morgan Howard.
Thank you to all my friends, family, and teachers that have pushed me to be the person I am today. Once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat.
Brandon Lee Hurley. Adriana Rose Hurt.
I just want to thank my friends and my family. And I know it's been hard, class of 2020, but we did it. It's crazy, but we did it.
Christy Lachey Isaac. Adolfo Izaguirre. Jeremy Dawson Jackson. Kennedy Andrell Jackson.
Hi, I'm Kennedy Jackson, and I would just like to thank everyone who has supported me through these long, stressful, yet fabulous high school years of mine.
Laquan Devion Jackson. Terrellis Josiah Jacobs. Alicia Miev James. Austin Blake Jenkins. Jaheim Rashad Jenkins. Tyneal Kiana Jenkins. Alexis Emerald Jester, Kennedy Deschanel Jester, Kania Atrial Johnson, Shinseer Christian Johnson, Danielle Nicole Jones, Amaya Tylea Jones, Jamea Leon Jones, Kentoria Alexis Jones, Madison Taylor Jones, Victoria Lachey Jones.
I want to thank my family and friends that supported me. My teachers that who helped with my attitude, who helped me get through this year.
Aubrey Grace Josie. Maria Guadalupe Juarez.
Thank you, family, friends, and teachers who supported me along my journey. My future plans are to attend SRTC and become an ultrasound technician.
Micaiah Janae Keaton. Carmen Elise Kayum. Jadelyn Latrice King. Carol Ann Kirkland. Dwayne Michael Kyles. Cody Hunter Lambert. Trey Bradley Lambert. Micah Adam Langdon.
Hi, I'm Micah Langdon, and I would like to congratulate all the seniors for moving on to bigger and better things this year. I would like to also thank my teachers and my parents. Congratulations.
Jamile Nikilia Lee. Hannah Ying Lin Lewis. Jariah Renee Lewis. Nita Shankila Lindsay. Jacob Bailey Long. Carson Michael Love. Katie Morgan Love. Blake Lawson Lowe.
I'm thankful for all the memories. I'm proud to be a Bearcat.
Brenda Felix Lucas. Lydia Lucas. Victoria Marie Lovano. Joanne Nicole Madrigal. Marisol Magana Lopez.
Hey, 2020, congrats to all of us for making it to our graduation this year. I'd like to give a special thanks to my family, my friends, and my teachers for pushing me to do better. And I wish all of you the best of luck.
Archivius DeCarlos Marshall.
Well, I made it right here. Thank you for all y'all for sticking with me today.
Asia Lasha Martin.
Love you, Mom. I love you, Dad. I love you, teachers and principals. I love you all.
Jarvis Tajiri Martin. Genesee Areli Martinez, Maribel Martinez Chavez, Ayana Lachey Masseline.
Thank you for all the congratulations and all the love and support you guys have given me.
Rebecca Morgan Mathis. Andrew Mason Matthews. Sarah Grace Matthews. Carly Michelle Maxwell.
Thanks to God for leading me down the path I am now, and a special thanks to my family and friends for the unending support. Class of 2020, we made it.
Zachary James Maxwell. Jeremiah Jermaine McLean. Tevin Devati McCray. Zavian Jaquel McFadden.
My name is Zay McFadden, and I want to thank family and friends for helping me achieve one of many milestones. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Robert Nix McIntosh. Alyssa Lissandra Medina. Dulce Emeteria Mendoza. Emily Maria Mendoza. Caroline Irene Middleton.
Thanks, BHS, for 4 memorable years. Class of 2020 forever.
Benjamin Edward Miller. Venteris Kejuan Miller.
And glory.
Joseph Millines.
Hello, I'm Joseph Millines, Jr. I am a 2020 graduate, and I'm thankful for everyone who made these 4 years amazing.
Jabez Austin Jones Minnis. Dahlia Rosemarie Minor.
Hi, my name is Dahlia Minor, and I'm a proud graduate of Bainbridge High School, class of 2020. Go Bearcats!
Dylan Ray Merrick. Brendan Ryan Mitchell. Elizabeth Grace Mobley. Artez Marquise Moore. Stokes Eli Moore. Brianna Celine Murphy. Mallory Camille Neal.
Hi, my name is Mallory Neal, and I thank God for where I'm at now. I am a senior, and I'm here to...
Jose Felipe Neves. Noemi Noriega. Shaquavia Charmaine Odom. Dylan Blaine Olds. Kyle Sebastian Olds. Malik Javon Olds. Sarah Macy Oliver. India Sana Regine Paris. Adam George Pasquale. Alex Bernard Pate. Gerald Andrew Peed. Christian Perez Salas. Diamond Nicole Perkins. Mikel Avante Jermaine Perkins. Antonio Deshaun Perry. Cortesia Lashaya Perry. Zatavian Zion Perry. Amari Javarius Peterson. Jalen Tyrell Peterson. Jameer Rashawn Peterson. Austin Allen Phillips. Lindsay Rebecca Phillips. Margaret Mackenzie Pickle. Riley Dixon Poitevant. Bradley Reed Ponder. Lorenzo Franklin Porter. Brandon Ryan Powell.
Hi, my name is Brandon Powell. I graduated class of 2020. My next step, United States Marine Corps.
Marley Nanel Powell. Connor Riggins Priest. Sandra Ramirez Perez. Nicholas Kane Ramos. Teriquan Dontavis Ray.
Hey, my name is Teriquan, and I want to thank my family and friends for helping me get through the last 4 years of high school. And hopefully I go to the army that pursue my career.
Bethany Carol Rents. Rosanna Megan Rents. Shelby Lynn Reynolds. David Lane Richardson. Fabiola Yesenia Rivera. Alexis Brianne Robinson. Jasmine Carlisha Robinson. Amanda Rodriguez.
My name is Amanda Rodriguez. I'm grateful for the love and support I'm receiving from my family and friends along this journey. I hope to become a neonatal nurse and a cardiologist in the future.
Brianna Dontasia Rogers.
Hi, I'm Brianna Rogers, and I just want to thank my family for all the support they have given me along this journey. Without them, I wouldn't be here.
Carter Scott Rogers. Jeremiah Amon Rogers. Cassie Lynn Roland. Rodolfo Ruiz, Jeremy Michael Ryan, Jesus Orlando Sanchez Arvizu, Gabriel Santiago.
I want to thank everyone who helped me through hard times, and I hope everyone is doing well during this pandemic. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Leah Danielle Sapp. Damian Alexander Scott, Jonathan Nathaniel Scott, Nigel Damon Screen, Alexis Shantae Senior.
To thank everybody that came around me with positive energy, and 2020 is the lit class of BHS, and that's on period. That's on.
Madison Katara Schumann.
Thank you to my mom, siblings, niece, and the rest of my family for all the love and support.
Michael Garrett Sigmund.
I'd like to thank my teachers and parents for helping me graduate.
Diana Maritza Silva. Frederick Christopher Simmons.
I just want to thank all my family and friends for all the support they gave me throughout high school.
Brittany Nicole Sims. Whitney Cheyenne Sledge. Natasha Alencia Small. Derek Terrell Smart.
Hey, I'm Derek, and I will be furthering my education at Bad Austin State University, majoring in criminal justice, and I just want to thank everyone for hearing who I am today.
Jonathan Latrivus Smart. Jasmine Alice Smith. Marquez Jayshon Smith. Miesia Nikiria Smith.
My name is Maya Smith, and upon graduation, I will be attending Middle Georgia State University, majoring in biology in hopes of furthering my career as an OBGYN.
Nicholas Scott Smith. Ryan Monroe Scott Smith. Tyhara Jarvania Smith.
And go.
Alika Julie Spay.
Thank you. I want to say thank you to all the friends and family who have always been there and supported me. Without your contribution, I would not be here, and I would not be the successful person I am today.
William Logan Spooner. Hannah Nicole Sprinkle. McKenna Brooke Stegall. Kalalisa Ann Strickland. Graciela Marie Surratt. Kyle William Swicord. Timothy Wendell Tarver. Derry Jonathan Tate. Faith Alyssa Taunton. Bailey Lane Thomas. Amber Maria Nicole McHale Thompson.
Jessica Austin, this is for you, baby.
Faith Nicole Thompson. Ronnie Thompson. Darielle Jabez Thornton. Elizabeth Michelle Tielson.
We did it!
Tanner Brian Timmons. Heather Nicole Tolliver. Javon Eugene Tomlin. Brittany Michelle Tomlinson. Sarah Renee Tubbs.
Thank you.
Destiny Kalia Turner. Noelle Grace Tyre.
4 years flew by too fast. Thank you to the teachers, family, and friends who shared this journey with me. I'm proud to be a Bainbridge High School graduate.
Naisha Nicole Valdez. Caleb Michael Varnum. Stacy Wayne Volgamore.
Hey everyone, I'm Stacy Volgamore, and my future plan is to attend the University of North Georgia and pursue a degree in sports medicine.
Taylor Kirkpatrick Wade. Amari Nasheer Walker. Mary Ansley Walker. Tamaya Chandraya Walker. Cyril Santel Walton. Shauna Lashande Washington. Zaria Sherelle Washington. Kelvin Denoris Wells. Madison Bailey West. Jackson Clay Wheeler.
Thank you so much to my parents and teachers for helping me along this big step in life.
Katie Alyssa White. Savannah Elena Kine White. Amari Tyrell Wilcher. Alvani Ferosoa Isolo Williams. Chastity Simone Williams. Christina Alexander Jean Williams. Ernest Lee Williams. LaShawn Shamore Williams. Michaela Juwante Williams. Janila Brianna Williford. Wyatt Woodrow Wilson.
I didn't think this would be how our graduation would take place. However, we're unstoppable. I'm praying our next chapter in life is made for greatness.
LaShawn Deandra Wimberly. Vic Lamar Wimberly. Cameron Bailey Wynn. Sarah Kaylee Wynn. Jacqueline Huerta Zaragoza.
On behalf of the faculty and staff at Bainbridge High School, I would like to congratulate the class of 2020 on reaching this important milestone in your life. Certainly, no one could have predicted or anticipated how this season of celebration during your senior year would be interrupted. Let it be said that we are proud of the accomplishments of the class of 2020, and we know you are destined for greatness. Remember to be the very best person you can be each and every day and follow these simple life lessons. Number one, always work hard in all that you do to overcome any deficiencies you may have. Number two, never forget where you came from. Once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat. Number three, be loyal. A person must be loyal in all aspects of life. Number four, courage. People must have courage. You must not balk at the sight of obstacles, COVID-19. Number five, desire. You must have a strong personal desire and a commitment to influence other people. Number six, emotional stamina. You must be able to recover rapidly from disappointment, bounce back from discouragement, and not lose perspective. Number seven, empathy. You must have an appreciation for and an understanding of the values of others. Number eight, competitiveness. An essential quality for any successful person is the desire to win. You must be competitive to win in this thing called life. Number nine, self-confidence. One must feel confident in themselves. A lack of self-confidence shows signs of weakness. Number 10, credibility. You must be credible. Your words and actions must be believable. Without credibility, one lacks influence. And number 11, dependability. If a person cannot be depended upon in all situations to carry out his or her roles and responsibilities, they must be removed. People are counting on you, class of 2020. If you follow these simple steps, I assure you that success will follow. Remember what Walt Disney said, all our dreams can come true if you have the courage to pursue them. We wish you the best, class of 2020.